Okay, good afternoon, class. In the last lecture, we have seen the k-mean clustering. Now today we will see the new topic that is called as a Gaussian mixture model, also called famous as a GMM. Okay. So before we start the Gaussian mixture model, let us see what are the limitation or what is that disadvantage of the k-means algorithm. So I am taking the one k-means algorithm output. Okay, this is the output of k-means algorithm. There are the total three data sets. They are used the three data sets, or red, green, and the blue colored dots. Okay, now you can see that there are the three value. Okay, so k1, I assign the value of k equal to 3. That's why there is a 3 cluster. So you can see that there are the 3 clusters. And this cluster having the centroid, like the k1, then there is another cluster. It is a k3 and this one, that is a k2. Okay, so how we can find out this cluster? So using the value of k equal to, defining the k equal to 3, we are getting the, we are dividing this data into the three different cluster, and we color them like the green, red, and the blue color. Okay, but the problem is that how we can be say that this data point is related to which cluster? Is it cluster coming in the k1, k2, or k3? Okay, so we cannot differentiate. We cannot find out exactly where this data point will be get fixed. Either it is in a k1, either it is in a k2, or either it is in a k3. So it is one of the problem we have to face in k-mean clustering, as it is a unsupervised machine learning algorithm, but it has some limitation. Let us see another one example. The drawback of k-mean clustering are, the k-mean clustering concept is simple to understand, relatively easy to implement, and can be applied in a quite number of use cases. But there are the certain drawbacks and limitations that we need to be aware of. Let us take some income expenditure example, as we saw about. The k-mean algorithm seems to be working pretty well, right? Hold on, if you look it closely, you will notice that all the clusters created have the circle shape. This is because of centroid of the cluster are updated iteratively and using the mean value. So this is an example of output of the k-mean clustering. Okay, by considering the income expenditure. Okay, so this income expenditure, you can see that now consider the following example where the distribution of the point is not in circular form. So you can see that here this distribution of point is not in a circular form, right? So what to do and will happen if the using k-mean clustering on this data? It will be still attained to group the data points in circular fashion. So it is very easy to find out the centroid if the data points are come in a circular form. Okay, so at this condition, our data set are not in a circular format. Okay, so how we can find out the k-mean? How we can find out the centroid? So it is very difficult to handle this condition, and this is one of the drawback of the k-mean clustering. So to overcome this problem, there is a one method called as a Gaussian mixture method, called as a GMM. The Gaussian mixture method model was developed by the Carl Friedrich Gaussian. It was invented in normal distribution in 1809 as the way of rationalizing the method of the least square. So he is the inventor of this mathematician, Mr. Carl Friedrich Gauss. So on the basis of his name, this model is called as a Gaussian mixture model. This is a basic formula for Gaussian model. For the dimension d, the Gaussian distribution of the vector x equal to x^1, x^2, x^b. Okay, x^t is defined by n of x mu of summation equal to 1 divided by 2 pi d divided by 2. Under root summation of pi expression exponential minus 1 by 2 x minus mu raised to the power t summation minus raised to the power 1 x minus mu, where mu is the mean and summation is the convergence matrix of the Gaussian. The example, you can see that this is the value of mu and this is the value of summation. So on the basis of that, we can get in this type of graph. Now you can easily find out using this graph, you can easily find out the centroid of the centroid, and you can differentiate or cluster the data point into the three types. Okay, green, then yellow, and red. Okay, so bottom is green, middle is the yellow, and upper points are related to the red. Okay, so easily we have to differentiate our data point into the three different points. So the Gaussian mixture model assume that there are a certain number of Gaussian distribution, and each of these distribution represent as a cluster. Hence, the Gaussian mixture model tends to group a data points belonging to the single distribution together. Let us say we have the three Gaussian distribution, named as GD1, GD2, and GD3. These have a certain mean value, that is mu1, mu2, and mu3, and it has a variance, that is alpha1, alpha2, and alpha3. For the given set of data points, our GMM could identify the probability of each data point belonging to each of these distributions. So, what is the definition for Gaussian mixture model? It is defined as Gaussian mixture model are probabilistic model and use the soft clustering approach for distributing the points in the different cluster. The probability given in a mixture of k Gaussian, and its formula is p of, that is the probability of given value x is equal to summation of j equal to 1 to k wj into n into x belonging to mu j and mu summation of j, where wj is the prior probability, that is the weight of the jth Gaussian. You can see when our data is g is equal to 1, so the graph is look like this, that is a dimensional 1 and this is a dimensional 2. So in the two dimensional, we are seeing that our data is look like this. So there are the three clusters we are getting. On the right hand side, you can see that this is a cluster 1, cluster 2, and cluster 3. So we have divided our data into the three clusters, and here we are also divided our data into the three clusters, cluster 1, cluster 2, and the cluster 3. So then we are giving the value of d equal to 1, and here we are giving the value of d equal to 2. Now take another example and let us see how this works. Here we have the three clusters that are denoted by the three colors, the blue color, the green color, and the cyan color. Let us take the point, data point highlighted in a red. The probability of this point being a part of the blue cluster is 1, while the probability of it being a part of the green and the cyan cluster is 0, obviously, because we are indicating, we are placing this data point at the blue cluster, so the probability of this cluster is a blue is 1 and other are the 0. Now consider the another point somewhere in between the blue and cyan, that is this point. So consider this point now. So this point is at the border of blue color dot and the cyan color dot. The probability that this point is a part of green cluster is 0, obviously, because it is very far from the green cluster, and the probability that this belonging to the blue and cyan are 0.2 and 0.8. Why? Because you can see carefully, this point is very much near to the cyan color as compared to the blue color. So that's why I am saying that there is a probability that 0.2 probability that this point is belonging to the blue color, and there is a probability 0.8 that this point is belonging to the cyan color. The Gaussian mixture model used the soft clustering technique for assigning the data points to the Gaussian distribution. So to solve this problem, we have used the Gaussian distribution, okay, and it is one of the techniques for assigning the data points. So what is that Gaussian distribution? The Gaussian distribution is also called as a normal distribution. It is a bell-shaped curve with a data point symmetrically distributed around the mean value. The below image has a few Gaussian distributions with a difference in a mu, that is mean, and the variance alpha square. Remember that the higher the alpha value, more will be the spread. Okay, so in this graph you can see that the mu is related to 0, 0 and mu is equal to minus 2. Okay, so you can see that this is the value, mu equal to 0, and alpha square is equal to 0.2, which is indicating by the blue line, alpha square is equal to 1, which is indicated by the red line, then 5.0 is a golden line, and 0.5 is a green line. Okay, so what did you say that the higher the mu value means higher the mu value means mu square 5.0 will be the its spread. So you can see that here this Gaussian distribution, this it is the highest point value, so it is get spread, so it is look like this, and this is the lowest point, that is a 0.2, so it is a, it is getting this the high, so it is the highest point. Okay, so this is a basic difference between the Gaussian distribution. Now let's see one example, then we will get the idea. In a one-dimensional space, the probability density function of the Gaussian distribution is given by f of x mu alpha square is equal to 1 by under root 2 by whole square e raised to the power minus x minus mu whole square divided by 2 alpha square, where mu is the mean and alpha is the variance. Okay, so the mu is indicating the mean value and the alpha square is indicating the variance of the value. In the case of two variable, instead of 2D bell shaped curve, we will have a 3D bell curve. Okay, so this is a three dimensional data. So using this three dimensional data, you can find out the bell curve. The probability density function will be given by f of x mu of summation equal to 1 divided by under root 2 pi summation exponential 1 minus 1 by 2 x minus mu raised to the power t e summation of raised to the power 1 into x minus mu, where x is the input vector and mu is the two-dimensional mean vector, and the summation is then 2 by 2 conversion matrix. The convergence will now define the shape of this curve. We can generalize the same for the d-dimensional. So we can use the one-dimensional, two-dimensional or three-dimensional data for representing the Gaussian distribution. Thus, this multivariate Gaussian model will have x and mu as a vector of the length d, and summation will be the d into d conversion matrix. So Gaussian distribution. Hence, for the data set with a d feature, we will have a mixture of k Gaussian distribution, each having the certain mean vector and the variance length. These values are determined using the technique called as a expectation maximization, EM. We need to understand this technique before we working on the Gaussian mixture model. So what is this EM, that is a expectation maximization? So this expectation maximization, indicating as a EM, is a statistical algorithm for finding the right model parameter. We typically use the EM when the data has missing of value, or in the other words, when the data is incomplete. So when you have the missing value in your data set, or when your data set is not completed, so in that case we have to use the expectation maximization. So as per your expectation, you have to change the value that is discounted of this expectation maximization. This missing value is called as a latent variable. So keep in mind that. What is the latent variable? Whatever the value is in your data set is called as a latent variable. Since we do not have the value for the latent variable, expectation maximization tries to use the existing data to determine the optimum value for this variable and then find the model parameter. Broadly, we can say that what expectation maximization is, this algorithm has divided into the two states, E state and the M state. So what is the E state? In this state, the available data is used to estimate, that is guesses, the value of missing variable. So you have to give the guesses of what is value your value is in this, and that state is called the E state. Putting by the M state. Based on the estimated value generated in the E state, the complete data is used to update the parameter. The expectation maximization is the base of many algorithms, including Gaussian mixture model. So, how does the GMM use the concept of EM, that is the expectation maximization, and how we can apply it for the given state of time? Let us find out. To understand the expectation maximization in Gaussian mixture model, let us consider this example so that we can get an idea how we can use the expectation EM model into the GMM. Let us say we need to assign the k number of clusters. The k value may be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, anything. This means that there are the k Gaussian distribution with the mean and the convergence value to be mu 1, mu 2, mu k and summation 1, summation 2 and summation k. Additionally, there is another parameter for the distribution that defines the number of points for the distribution, or in the other words, the density of the distribution is represented with a pi I. Now, we need to find the value of this parameter to define the Gaussian distribution. We already decide the number of clusters, randomly assign the value to the mean variance and the density. So you can randomly take the value of cluster, for example k equal to 3 or k equal to 4 or 5. So if you randomly select the value of k, then next we will perform the E state and the M state. So what is the formula to find out the E state? For each point xi, calculate the probability that is belonging to the cluster or the distribution C1, C2, Ck. C is indicating the cluster. And this is done using the below formula. RiC is equal to probability xi belonging to the C, that is the cluster C. The probability of x variable or x data belonging to the cluster C divided by the sum of the probability of xi belonging to x1, x2 or xk. Now let us consider there is one data is belonging to the male, is belonging to the boy, is belonging to the female or belonging to the girl. So you have to find out the probability. So let us consider I am giving the one value, and you can say that at that particular age, this data is belonging to the main category. So there is a probability that 1 divided by 4 is belonging to the cluster C1, that is the first. It is again differentiated like this, equal to pi of C raised to C of n xi mu C summation of C divided by summation of C pi C dash n xi n C dash
summation of C dash. This value be high when the point is assigned to the right cluster and lower otherwise. This is the end stage. After finding out the U stage, we go back and update the value of pi, where mu and alpha are mu and summation value. These are updated in the following manner. The new density defined by the ratio of number of points in the cluster and the total number of points, that is number of points assigned to the cluster divided by the total number of points, that is pi. Step, mean and the convergence matrix are updated based on the value assigned to the distribution in proportion with the probability value for the data point. Hence, data point that has a higher probability of being a part of that distribution will contribute the large portion equal to, so that mu equal to 1 by number of points assigned to the cluster into summation of I, R, I, C, H, I. So summation of T equal to 1 divided by the number of points assigned to the cluster, summation of I, R, I, C, in bracket, X, I minus mu, C raised to the power T, into X, I minus mu, C. Based on the updated value generated from the state, we calculate the new probabilities for each data point and update the value iteratively. This process is repeated in order to maximize the log likelihood function. So see, using this one of the practical approach, we can see that how the Gaussian mixture model is implemented. So let us consider there is a one data set, and in that data set we have divided these data set into the four clusters. Cluster 1, so this is the cluster 1, this is cluster 2, this is the cluster 3, and this is cluster 4. So there are the four clusters as the output of this data set. But as they are not circular in form, so it is very difficult to find out the centroid. So to avoid this, we have to use the GMM model. So now we call the GMM model. Okay. So this is the k-mean prediction. That gives the first k-mean model for this data. So when we use the k-mean model, so just you have to call the k-mean predict data. So you will get this type of output. So in which again, it is divided the data into the four clusters, cluster C1, cluster C2, cluster C3, and this is the cluster C3 and the cluster C4. But you can see that there is one problem in a k-mean cluster. And what is that problem? These black dots are belonging to this C3 as well as in a C4. The same point is also belonging to the cluster C3, and they are also belonging to the cluster C4. But it is not possible. So we have to divide our data set into the proper cluster. Okay. So how we can divide it? So instead of using the k-mean clustering, what we have to use? We have to use the Gaussian mixture. So now let us see using the Gaussian mixture. So here I am called the Gaussian mixture function, and now you can see that these clusters are perfectly divided into the four clusters, that is C1, C2 and C3 and C4. So using this same data set, we have divided our data set into the different cluster using the Gaussian mixture model.
Here we are used the 4 is indicating the cluster. Okay. And using the GNN predict, we are getting the prediction, and this prediction say that your data set is belonging to the this D1 is a sign color, then blue color is C2, green color is C3, and the black color is C4. So this is about the Gaussian mixture model. I hope you understand today's lecture using the example. What do you mean by the Gaussian mixture model, and how we have to implement the Gaussian mixture model?